गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 27 ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग थर्मोडायनेमिक्स। इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव स्टार्टेड न्यू यूनिट, दैट इज यूनिट नंबर 4। प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ प्योर सब्सटेंस, फर्स्ट पार्ट इज प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ प्योर सब्सटेंस इन विच वी हैव टू स्टडी अबाउट दिस स्टीम। वी हैव सीन थ्री डिफरेंट फॉर्म ऑफ वाटर, दैट इज लिक्विड, सॉलिड एंड गैसियस। टुडे वी विल सी how liquid is converted into steam, what are the different processes to transform liquid into vapor, water into steam. Perfect gas, we have already seen the definition of perfect gas. Perfect gas is a gas which is perfectly in the form of gas. It is also called as a permanent gas, the gas which cannot be converted into liquid. The gas which cannot be converted into liquid, such gases are called as perfect gas. But this was a old theory. This was an old theory that the gas cannot be converted into, some gas cannot be converted into liquid. This was an old theory. But according to new theory, there is no gas which cannot be converted into liquid. Every gas can be converted into liquid by condensing it. Therefore, according to new theory, perfect gas is a gas which follows ideal gas equation. A gas which does not change its phase during a thermodynamic process. The gas which does not change its phase during thermodynamic process is called as a perfect gas. Or we can say it is a temporary gas. Or for the sake of the particular process, it does not changes its phase. Pure substance, we have already seen pure substance, it is a homogeneous substance that retains its chemical composition even though it undergoes a change in phase during a thermodynamic process. Consider water. Water consists of H2O. If water is condensed, if water is freezed, water will convert into ice. Ice is also pure substance, water is also pure substance, because composition of both is H2O. If we take a mixture of water and ice, it is also pure substance because composition of mixture is H2O. If we take a mixture of water and steam, liquid water and steam, it is also pure substance because composition of steam is H2O and composition of water is also H2O. Water is one of the pure substance which can exist in three different phases, that we have seen in solid phase, in liquid phase and gaseous phase. In solid phase it is ice, in liquid phase it is water, in gaseous phase it is steam. This is solid. In solid, all the molecules are properly spaced and there is a intermolecular force, there is a strong intermolecular force, and because of that force they are at, the molecules are in their own position, they are not changing the position. If the solid is heated, and when the solid convert into liquid, when the solid is melted, it convert into liquid. The molecules are liquid are randomly spaced, they are not they can move about the other molecule, the position is not fixed, but they cannot leave the boundary, molecules cannot leave the boundary. But if liquid is heated, the liquid vaporizes, the water is heated, water vaporizes and convert into steam, and steam is a gas. The gas molecules, there is a no molecular attraction between the molecules, they are randomly moving away from each other. Now change of state or phase transition is a change of substance from one state to another state. Change of state or phase is conversion of solid into liquid and liquid into vapor from one phase to another phase. I have shown here three phases. सॉलिड फेज, लिक्विड फेज एंड गैसियस फेज। देर आर सम सब्सटेंस विच कैन कन्वर्ट फ्रॉम सॉलिड टू लिक्विड, फर्स्ट देन लिक्विड टू गैस ड्यूरिंग हीटिंग एंड ड्यूरिंग कूलिंग। गैस कन्वर्ट इन टू लिक्विड एंड लिक्विड कन्वर्ट इन टू सॉलिड ड्यूरिंग कूलिंग। बट देर आर सम सब्सटेंस विच कैन कन्वर्ट फ्रॉम सॉलिड टू गैस डायरेक्टली ड्यूरिंग हीटिंग एंड ड्यूरिंग कूलिंग। इट कन्वर्ट्स फ्रॉम गैस टू सॉलिड डायरेक्टली विदाउट द फेज ऑफ लिक्विड स्टेट। लेट अस सी, इफ द सॉलिड इज हीटेड सॉलिड मेल्ट्स एंड कन्वर्ट इन टू लिक्विड। इफ द सॉलिड इज हीटेड सॉलिड मेल्ट्स एंड कन्वर्ट इन टू लिक्विड। दिस प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड एज अ मेल्टिंग प्रोसेस। सपोज वॉटर इज कूल्ड, वॉटर इज कूल्ड एंड वॉटर इज कन्वर्टेड इन टू आइस। द लिक्विड इज कूल्ड एंड लिक्विड इज कन्वर्टेड इन टू सॉलिड। देन दिस प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड एज अ फ्रीजिंग प्रोसेस। इफ द हीट इज एक्सट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम वॉटर इट विल कन्वर्ट इन टू सॉलिड एंड दैट इट विल कन्वर्ट इन टू आइस एंड दिस प्रोसेस विल बी कॉल्ड एज फ्रीजिंग प्रोसेस। इफ द आइस इज हीटेड एंड इट विल कन्वर्ट इन टू वॉटर, दिस प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड एज अ मेल्टिंग प्रोसेस। When the liquid is heated, it convert into gas. Liquid, when the liquid is heated, it will convert into gas. And the process of formation of gas from the liquid is called a boiling process. During boiling process, saturated liquid is convert into saturated gas or saturated vapor. This process is called as a boiling process. During boiling process, liquid convert into gas. Now, if you want to convert gas into liquid, we have to cool it. When the gas is cooled, it will convert into liquid, and that process is called as a condensation. The cooling of gas into liquid is called as a condensation. Cooling of liquid to solid is called as a freezing process. Heating of solid to liquid is called as a melting, and heating of liquid to gas is called as a boiling process. Now, there are some processes like sublimation. Sublimation is a process in which solid directly convert into gas. This process takes place in camphor. When we burn the camphor, camphor doesn't melt. Camphor directly convert from solid to gas. The another process in which gas can be directly converted into solid. This process is called as a deposition process or condensation process. You might have seen when we run any engine from the silencer, the smoke is coming out, the burn gases is coming out. Burn gases consist of carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide is a black gas. When the carbon monoxide is deposited at the end of this silencer, after some time it gets into the solid form. The gas is converting into solid because of the deposition of the particulate matter of a gas at the end of silencer. When the gas is depositing, when the solid part of the gas is depositing in the silencer continuously, it form layer of that powder particle. And that powder, the solid form of that powder particle is nothing but a formation of solid from gas. It is called as a deposition. That solid is formed by the deposition of gas particle in the silencer. Phase change process of a pure substance. Look at here. In the container, there is a water at 0 degree Celsius. Water from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius is called as a subcooled water or compressed water. Water from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius, or you can say slightly below the 100 degree Celsius, is called as a subcooled water or condensed water. When heat is supplied to the water at 0 degree Celsius, it changes its temperature temperature of water increases and the heat is supplied is called as a sensible heat. Heat is supplied is called as a sensible heat. Now in the second container, it is a water above the 0 degree Celsius. Above 0 degree Celsius. When water is heated and the temperature increases, specific volume of water increases. You might have seen that when water is being heated, hot water come at the top of the water layer and the lower layer is a cold. When the water is heated, hot part of water come at the top layer, and when it is transferring, the density also changing, its density decreasing. As the density decreases, specific volume increases. Now here, water is at 100 degree Celsius. Here water was 0 degree Celsius. Water is heated from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius. Now here it is a water at 100 degree Celsius. We are talking about the atmospheric pressure. We are talking about the atmospheric pressure, and atmospheric pressure is 1 atmosphere, and 1 atmosphere is equal to 1.01325 bar. At atmospheric pressure, 100 degree Celsius is the saturation temperature of water. Now what is mean by saturation temperature of water? Saturation temperature of water means, now after supplying a further heat, it will convert into vapor. After supplying heat further, it will convert into water. Here water is at 100 degree Celsius. Water is heated from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius. We have supplied sensible heat. Now what is sensible heat? Sensible heat is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of water from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius. Means heat is supplied from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius is a latent heat. Sensible heat. Sensible heat is required to raise the temperature. Now here water is at 100 degree Celsius. To convert water into vapor, we have to supply latent heat. Latent heat of vaporization. Now here we'll supply latent heat of vaporization so that water will convert into steam. You can see upper layer of water. When we supply the latent heat, upper layer of water started boiling and converted into steam. Steam is a gaseous form, therefore volume of this part will increase. Now here it is a mixture of water and vapor. The lower portion is a water and upper portion is a vapor or steam. It is saturated liquid and it is saturated vapor. And the mixture of saturated vapor and saturated liquid is called as a wet steam. Wet steam means mixture of dry steam and water. Now you can see there is a mixture. Now it is not converted completely into vapor. It is a mixture of water and vapor now. It means latent heat is, supply of latent heat is going on. We are still supplying the latent heat. When we are supplying latent heat completely, the whole part of water will convert into steam. Here you can see this is a steam, completely steam. It is a saturated steam. This steam is called as a saturated steam. This is a saturated water and this is saturated steam. Saturated water temperature is 100 degree Celsius and saturated steam temperature is also 100 degree Celsius. It means transformation of saturated water into saturated steam takes place at 100 degree Celsius and mixture is also at 100 degree Celsius. From this we conclude that during phase change, temperature remains constant. During phase change of water from liquid state to vapor state, temperature remains constant. Therefore, remember one thing, during phase change, temperature remains constant. During phase change only, latent heat is added or latent heat is removed. For the conversion of liquid into vapor, we have to add latent heat. and for the conversion of vapor into liquid we have to remove latent heat. Now here it is a completely vapor, but it is a saturated vapor. Saturated vapor means at 100 degree Celsius. Now we can heat this saturated vapor further by adding sensible heat, and the temperature of this steam will exceed the zero de- will exceed 100 degree Celsius, and that heat is called as a heat of superheat, heat of superheated steam, and that part of a steam is called as superheated steam or superheated vapor. When the water is below 100 degree Celsius, then it is called as subcooled liquid or condensed liquid. When the water is at 100 degree Celsius, then it is called as saturated water. The mixture of water and vapor is called as a wet steam. The steam at 100 degree Celsius or saturated state is called as a saturated vapor. When the saturated vapor is heated further, it converts into superheated vapor. And we can increase the temperature of superheated vapor further by adding sensible heat. Look at here. Here liquid is in a subcooled form. When the liquid is heated, it converts into saturated liquid. Then saturated liquid is heated. The part of saturated liquid transforming into vapor, at a lower portion it is a liquid and it is a vapor. Therefore it is a mixture of water and vapor. When the liquid completely converted into vapor, then it is a saturated vapor. Then if we heat saturated vapor further, it becomes superheated vapor or superheated steam. Phase change process of pure substance. Compressed liquid, also called as subcooled liquid. Compressed liquid or subcooled liquid means at atmospheric pressure, temperature below 100 degree Celsius. We know that at atmospheric pressure, water boils at 100 degree Celsius. Water boils at 100 degree Celsius. And the temperature at which water start boil is called as a saturation temperature of water. Therefore, compressed liquid or subcooled liquid is a temperature below 100 degree Celsius, a substance that it is not about to vaporize. It is a substance which is not about to vaporize. Suppose temperature is 90 degree Celsius, 80 degree Celsius, water is not about to vaporize because water will vaporize at 100 degree Celsius at atmospheric pressure. Therefore, the temperature, any temperature below 100 degree Celsius at atmospheric pressure is a compressed liquid or subcooled liquid up to 0 degree Celsius, okay, because below 0 degree Celsius it will convert into solid, that is ice. Saturated liquid, a liquid that is about to vaporize, saturated liquid that is about to vaporize means at atmospheric pressure water at 100 degree Celsius. At atmospheric pressure, water at 100 degree Celsius is a saturated liquid, because at 100 degree Celsius, when we supply the latent heat, water will convert into vapor. Look at here, in a cylinder, at atmospheric pressure, the water is at 20 degree Celsius. Water is at 20 degree Celsius means less than 100 degree Celsius. Therefore, water is a subcooled or compressed liquid. At one atmosphere, that is 20 degree Celsius, water exists in a liquid state, that is compressed liquid. Now when we supply the heat, the temperature will increase from 20 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius at constant pressure. We are not going to change the pressure. The water is heated at atmospheric pressure from 20 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius. Now the one atmospheric pressure means atmospheric pressure. The pressure of surrounding or the atmosphere. Here the pressure of water is atmosphere pressure and temperature is 100 degree Celsius. It means it is a saturated liquid. It is a saturated water at 1 atmosphere pressure and 100 degree Celsius, water exists as a liquid that is ready to vaporize. That is ready to vaporize. The liquid ready to vaporize means it is a saturated liquid now. It is saturated. Its temperature cannot be increased further. Its temperature cannot be increased further, maintaining the same pressure. When we try to heat it further, it will convert into vapor. Saturated vapor, a vapor that is about to condense. Saturated vapor that is about to condense. When the saturated water converted into vapor, when we remove the heat, when we remove the latent heat, it will convert into liquid. That is, it is about to condense. A saturated liquid vapor mixture, saturated liquid and saturated vapor mixture, the state at which the liquid and vapor phase coexist in equilibrium. It is a mixture of saturated water and saturated vapor that we have seen in the last part. It is a mixture of water and vapor where both phase coexist, both phase, liquid phase as well as gaseous phase coexist. It is called as a wet steam. Superheated vapor. Superheated vapor means the saturated vapor is heated further. Saturated vapor is heated further by adding sensible heat to raise the temperature. At atmospheric pressure, if the steam has a temperature above 100 degrees Celsius, then it is called as a superheated vapor. A vapor that is not about to condense. Suppose the steam is at, or the vapor is at 120 degrees Celsius at atmospheric pressure. And if we are removing the heat, first of all, the temperature of 120 degrees Celsius steam will convert, will come to the 100 degrees Celsius. From 120 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius, it will remain in the vapor state. But at 100 degrees Celsius, it will start condensing. Therefore, superheated steam is a steam which is not about to condense unless and until it is bring to the saturated state. Consider a cylinder in which water is at, mixture is at 1 atmosphere and temperature at 100 degrees Celsius. Lower part is a saturated liquid and upper part is a saturated vapor. And it means when we are adding it, it is just boiling. Just boiling. Therefore, the water has reached to the saturated liquid state. And during boiling process, water is converted into vapor. Therefore, at a upper part, it is a saturated vapor. At lower part, it is a saturated liquid. And the vapor contains the part of a liquid also. Therefore, it is called as a mixture of water and vapor. It is called as a mixture of water and vapor. Now, when the complete part of water is converted into vapor, then it is called as a saturated vapor. Now, here you can see it is a vapor. It is a vapor at 100 degrees Celsius, and this vapor is called as a saturated vapor because it is 100 degrees Celsius, saturated vapor. Suppose if we remove the latent heat, saturated steam will convert into saturated water. When the saturated steam is heated further at same temperature, it convert into superheated steam. Even though temperature increased by 1 degree Celsius, if the temperature of this steam is 101 degree Celsius at 1 atmosphere, it is superheated steam. Temperature above 100 degree Celsius, any temperature above 100 degree Celsius at atmospheric pressure is a superheated steam. It is a superheated form of steam. We can raise its temperature from 100 degrees Celsius to anything. Anything means the maximum temperature that can be achieved is 375 डिग्री सेल्सियस, 374 डिग्री सेल्सियस एट एटमोस्फेरिक प्रेशर। इफ द प्रेशर इज रेज टू 221 bar एंड टेम्परेचर रेज टू 374 डिग्री सेल्सियस, देन वॉटर डायरेक्टली कन्वर्ट इंटू वेपर विदाउट बॉइलिंग। विल सी दैट पार्ट इन लेटर केस। लुक एट हियर, इट इज अ सबकूल्ड लिक्विड, इट इज अ सबकूल्ड लिक्विड एट 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस। नाउ टू कन्वर्ट सबकूल्ड लिक्विड इंटू सैचुरेटेड लिक्विड वी हैव टू सप्लाई सेंसिबल हीट। वेन द सेंसिबल हीट इज सप्लाइड, टेम्परेचर इज इंक्रीज फ्रॉम 20 डिग्री सेल्सियस टू 100 डिग्री सेल्सियस। वेन द टेम्परेचर ऑफ लिक्विड इंक्रीज, वॉल्यूम इज ऑल्सो इंक्रीज। वी आर स्टडिंग द टेम्परेचर वॉल्यूम डायग्राम, टीवी डायग्राम। When we supply the sensible heat to the water at 20 degree Celsius, temperature increases as well as volume increases. Now 0.2 represents the saturated liquid at 100 degree Celsius. At atmospheric pressure, 100 degree Celsius is a saturation temperature. Now at 0.2, water is at a saturated liquid state. To convert saturated liquid into saturated vapor, we have to supply latent heat. When we supply latent heat to saturated liquid, it will convert into saturated vapor. Now 0.2 represents saturated liquid, 0.4 represents saturated vapor, and the portion between 0.2 and 0.4 is a mixture of water and vapor. Consider 0.3. 0.3 represents mixture of water and vapor. At 0.2, it is 100% liquid. At 0.4, it is 100% vapor. If it is a 1/6 part and it is a 1/4 part, the 1/6 part and it is a 1/4 part, then 60% vapor and 40% liquid. 60% vapor and 40% liquid. The 0.3 represents that 60% of water is converted into vapor and remaining 40% it to convert into vapor. 0.4 represents saturated vapor, means here at 0.4 complete liquid is converted into vapor. No liquid is remaining, all part of liquid has been converted into vapor. If we supply heat further, it will convert into superheated vapor. It will convert into superheated vapor. 0.5 represents superheated vapor. Even though, if we take point here, it is a superheated vapor. Any temperature above 100 degrees Celsius is a superheated vapor at atmospheric pressure. This process can be reversed. This process can be reversed by removing the heat. By cooling, consider 0.5. At 0.5, it is a superheated steam at atmospheric pressure. If superheated steam is condensed first, if superheated steam is cooled first, superheated steam will convert into saturated steam. If you remove the latent heat, saturated steam will convert into saturated water. If you condense it again, if you cool it again, the saturated water will convert into subcooled water. We'll see what is vaporization. Vaporization is a process of conversion of liquid into vapor or gas. And this vaporization process takes place at saturation temperature only. And saturation temperature is that temperature at which phase transformation takes place, at which phase change takes place. When water is heated beyond a boiling point, when water is heated beyond boiling point means 100 degrees Celsius at atmospheric pressure, it starts vaporizing and transformation from liquid phase to gaseous phase to form steam. Vaporization process means transformation of liquid phase to vapor phase. Important properties of steam are pressure, temperature, specific volume, enthalpy, entropy, and internal energy. These are the properties of the steam. We'll see these properties in numerical part. Phase change process of water. We'll discuss again what we have seen. Water at 20 degrees Celsius is heated at atmospheric pressure. Water at 20 degrees Celsius is a subcooled liquid or compressed liquid. It is being heated at 1 atmosphere. At 20 degrees Celsius, it is a subcooled water. When the water is heated to 100 degrees Celsius, no vaporization occurs. Water is heated up to 100 degrees Celsius, but vaporization not yet started. This state is called as a saturated water. At 100 degrees Celsius, vaporization begins. If latent heat of vaporization is added. Look at here. When water is at heated to 100 degrees Celsius, vaporization not yet started, because we have not supplied latent heat. When we supplied latent heat, at 100 degrees Celsius, vaporization start. It means water will convert into gas only when latent heat of vaporization is added. Unless and until latent heat of vaporization is added, water will not change its phase. If the latent heat of vaporization is added to saturated water, it gets converted into saturated vapor. By adding latent heat, saturated water will convert into saturated vapor. Phase change from water to vapor happens at constant temperature. Phase change takes place at constant temperature always for any substance. At 100 degrees Celsius, it is a saturated liquid. At 100 degrees Celsius, it is a saturated vapor. It means when it was a water, temperature was 100 degrees Celsius. When it is a vapor, temperature is again 100 degrees Celsius. This transformation of water into steam takes place at constant temperature. During phase change, temperature doesn't change. Heat required for phase change is called as a latent heat. To change the phase, we need to supply latent heat. Any further heat addition is called sensible heat, which will only superheat the vapor and increase its temperature without any change in phase. When the water is converted into vapor completely, it is called as saturated vapor. At saturation temperature, when we add heat further, that heat is called as a sensible heat. By adding sensible heat to the saturated vapor, it will change the temperature of vapor. And that vapor is called as a superheated vapor. Now, what is latent heat? Latent heat of vaporization. Latent heat is required to change the phase. Latent heat of vaporization is a heat required to convert liquid into vapor. There are two types of latent heat. Latent heat of evaporation and latent heat of fusion. Latent heat of evaporation means latent heat required to convert liquid into vapor. Heat required to evaporate 1 kg of liquid into saturated vapor at 100 degrees Celsius is called a latent heat of evaporation. Next, latent heat of fusion. Latent heat of fusion means to convert solid into latent heat required to convert solid phase into liquid phase. Heat required to liquefy 1 kg of ice into saturated liquid. When we convert ice into water, this heat is called as a heat of fusion. When we convert liquid into vapor, it is called as a latent heat of vaporization. Look at a TV diagram. We have already seen TV diagram. Here it is, subcooled water is at 20 degrees Celsius. When heat is added, its temperature increases and volume also increases. Specific volume also increases. And water reaches to saturated temperature. Here it is saturated liquid, completely liquid, 100% liquid, but it is a saturated form. Saturated form means now it can transform into vapor at 100 degrees Celsius. At 100 degrees Celsius, when we add a latent heat, it will convert into saturated vapor. This is a phase change process. It is 100% liquid, it is 100% vapor. And the middle portion represents the sum part of liquid, sum part of vapor. If we consider this point, this is more than 50%, consider it is 60%. Means 60% of water is converted into steam. Only 40% of water it to convert into steam. Therefore, this is a mixture of 60% steam and 40% water. Here, it is a completely liquid, it is saturated liquid, it is a completely vapor, it is saturated water. And saturated water, saturated vapor, not water, saturated vapor is called as a dry steam. Saturated vapor is called as a dry steam. Means dryness fraction is a 1 for saturated steam. For saturated liquid, dryness fraction is 0. Or we can see here, it is 100% dry and it is 0% dry. When the water start converted into vapor, the percentage of dryness increases. Percentage of dryness increases. Suppose here 10%, 20% dryness, 30% dryness, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. At this point, it is about 60% dry, with 60% steam and 40% water. Here 100% dry, is 100% steam and 0% water. This is saturated vapor. Temperature remains constant from saturated liquid to saturated vapor. Now it has been converted into saturated vapor. Now we can increase its temperature further by adding sensible heat. And where the temperature increases is called as sensible heat. Look at here. Here the temperature increases. Whenever the temperature increases, we are adding sensible heat. Here also temperature increases, we are adding sensible heat. Here phase change takes place. We are adding latent heat. Whenever heat is supplied to change the phase is called as a latent heat. Whenever heat is supplied to change the phase is called as a latent heat. And whenever heat is supplied to raise the temperature is called as a sensible heat. Here heat is supplied to raise the temperature, therefore we are adding sensible heat. Here also heat is supplied to raise the temperature, we are adding sensible heat. And here heat is supplied to change the phase, therefore it is a latent heat. Consider again one more diagram. It is a temperature enthalpy diagram, TH diagram. Consider water is at 0 degree Celsius. It is a water at 0 degree Celsius. When we heat water from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius at surrounding temperature, at surrounding pressure means 1 atmospheric pressure. When the water is heated from 0 degree Celsius to 100 degree Celsius, we are supplying sensible heat, and that sensible heat is called as a HF. HF, F represents the fluid. In case of steam, in case of this chapter, liquid is called as a fluid. Liquid is represented by F. Therefore, we need to supply sensible heat of liquid. Sensible heat of liquid is represented by HF. Now here, it is a saturated liquid. To convert saturated liquid into saturated vapor, we need to supply latent heat. We need to supply latent heat. Therefore, this portion represents supply of latent heat. This portion represents latent heat. Look at here. Latent heat is represented by HFG. F stands for fluid and G stands for gas. Gas means vapor. लैटेंट हीट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय एच एफ जी, ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑफ फ्लूड इंटू द हीट रिक्वायर्ड टू ट्रांसफॉर्म फ्लूड इंटू गैस, हीट रिक्वायर्ड टू ट्रांसफॉर्म फ्लूड इंटू गैस. एक्चुअली फ्लूड इज बोथ लिक्विड एंड गैस, बोथ आर फ्लूड, बट इन केस ऑफ दिस चैप्टर एफ स्टैंड्स फॉर लिक्विड. देयरफॉर एच एफ जी इज अ लैटेंट हीट रिक्वायर्ड टू ट्रांसफॉर्म लिक्विड इंटू गैस. नाउ द टोटल हीट रिक्वायर्ड टू कन्वर्ट 0 डिग्री सेल्सियस वाटर इंटू 100 डिग्री सेल्सियस सैचुरेटेड वेपर इज इक्वल टू एच एफ प्लस एच एफ जी, एच एफ प्लस एच एफ जी. नाउ हियर इट इज सैचुरेटेड वेपर, सैचुरेटेड स्टीम. आई वॉन्ट टू इंक्रीज इट्स टेम्परेचर फर्दर, आई वॉन्ट टू इंक्रीज इट्स टेम्परेचर फर्दर बाय एडिंग सेंसिबल हीट. नाउ इट इज अ सैचुरेटेड वेपर एंड हियर इट इज अ सुपरेटेड वेपर. देयरफॉर टेम्परेचर डिफरेंस बिटवीन सैचुरेटेड वेपर एंड सुपरेटेड वेपर इज कॉल्ड एज अ डिग्री ऑफ सैचुरेशन, इज कॉल्ड एज अ डिग्री ऑफ सैचुरेशन. नाउ द टेम्परेचर बिटवीन सैचुरेटेड लिक्विड एंड सबकूल्ड लिक्विड इज कॉल्ड एज अ डिग्री ऑफ सबकूल्ड, इज कॉल्ड एज अ डिग्री ऑफ सबकूल्ड. इफ द टेम्परेचर इज अ डिक्रीज फ्रॉम सैचुरेटेड लिक्विड टू सबकूल्ड लिक्विड इज कॉल्ड एज अ डिग्री ऑफ सबकूल्ड. एंड द टेम्परेचर बिटवीन सैचुरेटेड वेपर टू सुपरेटेड वेपर इज कॉल्ड एज अ डिग्री ऑफ सुपरहीट. नाउ टू रेज द टेम्परेचर ऑफ सैचुरेटेड लिक्विड टू सुपरेटेड सॉरी सैचुरेटेड वेपर टू सुपरेटेड वेपर वी नीड टू सप्लाई सेंसिबिलिटी, दैट सेंसिबिलिटी कॉल्ड एज सुपरहीट, दैट सेंसिबिलिटी कॉल्ड एज अ सुपरहीट. नाउ द टोटल एंथैल्पी सप्लाइड फ्रॉम 0 डिग्री सेल्सियस टू से इट इज 120 डिग्री सेल्सियस. Therefore, enthalpy supplied or the heat supplied from 0 degree Celsius to 120 degree Celsius is called as heat enthalpy of superheat, enthalpy of superheat, which is represented by H sup, which is represented by H sup. The enthalpy or the heat required to convert 0 degree Celsius water into 100 degree Celsius steam इट्स कॉल्ड एज अ एंथैल्पी ऑफ इवापोरेशन, एंथैल्पी ऑफ इवापोरेशन एच ई और टोटल एंथैल्पी. ओके सपोज कंसिडर एनी पॉइंट, आई हैव शोन हियर 3.1, 2, 3. कंसिडर दिस फर्स्ट पॉइंट, हियर 30% वेपर एंड 70% वॉटर, 30% वेपर एंड 70% वॉटर. इट मीन्स ड्राइनेस फ्रैक्शन इज 0.3, ड्राइनेस फ्रैक्शन इज 0.3. इफ आई वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट एंथैल्पी एट दिस पॉइंट, एंथैल्पी एट दिस पॉइंट, वी नो द एंथैल्पी ऑफ दिस फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट टू दिस पॉइंट फ्रॉम 0 डिग्री सेल्सियस टू 100 डिग्री सेल्सियस इट इज एच एफ. एंड फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट टू दिस पॉइंट आई हैव टू एड लैटेंट हीट बट 30% लैटेंट ओनली बिकॉज 30% स्टीम, ओनली 30% स्टीम एंड 70% वॉटर, ओनली 30% water is converted into steam. Therefore, I have to add 30% latent heat. Therefore, enthalpy at this point will be equal to HF plus X HFG. HFG is a latent heat and X is a 30%. H is a dryness fraction. X is a dryness fraction. And here dryness fraction is 30%. Therefore, HF plus 0.3 HFG will be the enthalpy at this point. Consider enthalpy at this point. Suppose here it is 50% vapor and 50% liquid. Therefore, dryness fraction is 0.5. Then enthalpy at this point will be HF plus 0.5 HFG. The dryness fraction will be given in the problem. Suppose dryness fraction here is a 0.8 and we want to calculate enthalpy at this point. Therefore, the enthalpy will be HF plus 0.8 HFG. We'll see the formula in the next lecture. Okay, this part we'll see in the next lecture.